Hey guys, Andrei here. Welcome to another video, and today we are in the heart of Lincoln Park. And this car is almost as stylish and cool as the property that I'm about to show you. Let's go tour it. Welcome to 936 West Montana Street, Residence 101. This home has 4 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, 1 half bath, 3,500 square feet of interior living space, and over 1,300 square feet of outdoor space. Listed for $1,450,000. Development by O'Neill Development Group. And a huge thank you to listing agent Josh Lipton for letting me tour his amazing listing. Guys, welcome to Unit 101. I'm very excited to show you this home. And before we start the tour, let me just point out the best feature of this home, at least in my opinion, and that is the sheer size of it. The developer built this building on a 75-foot lot, so it's actually 3 city lots. On a standard 25-foot city lot, drywall to drywall, you're usually about 17 to 18 feet. In this home, it's 28 feet. So less units, but much bigger, much wider, which is why this unit looks the way that it does. Okay, in front of the house, we have this large scale sitting room. And this area is truly, truly large. If you notice, this couch is at least like 110, maybe 115 inches long. And this space actually kind of dwarfs it, right? And this is not one coffee table, but it's actually 2 combined. So this sitting room feels like one you would find in like a mansion, like in a Lincoln Park single family house. And right off your sitting room is your first terrace. And this is your front terrace in front of the house. And notice the entire wall is basically your sliding doors, which is really, really impressive. Natural light basically pours through this entire wall of windows into the main level, which is really, really awesome. So right over here is your front terrace. And guys, notice the pavers. They have this nice texture to them, and they have this nice color to them, and they look really expensive. And that's the thing about this home. As I walk you through the entire space, you'll see that every inch of the home is perfectly crafted, and the quality is on a whole nother level. All right, let's talk about this kitchen because I think it's amazing, and let me show you guys exactly what makes it amazing. So first of all, it's the quality, it's the selection of brands and all the appliances, and it's the innovative design. So everything is just so well put together, it flows beautifully, and it looks awesome. Okay, let's talk about this range because it is beautiful. It has 5 burners. It's by a French company called La Cornue. I think I pronounced it right. And this is one of the most expensive ranges money can buy. These things range from $10,000 to like $50,000. I'm not sure what this model is, but it looks very, very expensive. You've got gold and stainless steel, and you've got these massive handles. And it actually has this really nice shade of black. Very cool. And this thing actually takes like 60 people to assemble. Yeah, this is a work of art. And these cabinets are pure perfection. Like you could see every screw, every detail, even the inside of the cabinets, it's absolutely flawless. And it's like a nice shade of gray. And notice the height of it. I don't even know how you reach that one. And this much cabinetry can only mean one thing, lots of storage. So you have your integrated Sub-Zero fridge with a freezer. I'm a big fan of the hardware they used on the cabinets. So on the integrated appliances, notice the handles are longer and they're modern. They're very clean. And then on the drawers right here, they actually went with a different shape. They're shorter, they're a little more classic. And then they have these square knobs that look really nice also. Very bold. Let's talk about this island. First of all, it's really large, really deep. You got a nice overhang. You could sit like 5 people here, maybe 6 people. I like to exaggerate, it's actually 4 chairs. And usually with islands, folks like to pop them out in a bolder color, you know, in a gray or a black or something like that, or even green. In this kitchen, they actually flipped it. So the kitchen itself is in a darker gray, and then the island is in crisp white. And because of the size of it, it actually doesn't get lost. It still looks bold, it still looks beautiful. And right over the island, you have this really unique light fixture that looks like it's one of a kind. It's mysterious, and it gives off this really cool reflection in the ceiling. And right over here is the perfect spot for your dining room table. And this table is very wide and is very long. When you have a floor plan this wide, you can afford to put any size dining room table. Adjacent to your kitchen is this powder room that services the main level. Very dark, very moody. You have this antique mirror that's oversized. Two beautiful sconces, well, they're not sconces, light fixtures coming off the ceiling. Very bold brass faucet. Very well designed. My second favorite feature of this home is the two-tiered main level. This is something you don't see in any other home. I really appreciate the dark gray railing with these matte black spindles. Looks very modern, very clean, but also keeps it very open. And here's your family room. Again, great size family room. You have this modern light fixture right over it. The light fixture is very cool and very stylish. It adds a lot of character to the living room, and it actually enhances the entire space. Right over here, you have a gas fireplace, and you can actually start it with just one push of a button right over here. On each side of the fireplace, you have these really nice built-ins. They're practical, they're beautiful to look at, and they even installed these brass picture lights over them. Very thoughtful. And the upper main level is so large that you actually have enough space for another sitting area. And this is the perfect place to actually make it your library nook, or you can actually make it your bar as well. Lots of options. And this over here is a 1300 square foot private terrace. That's private just to your unit. So if you love to entertain, this is all you. One of the nice things about this outdoor space is the fact that a part of it is covered. So if it's snowing or raining and you still want to be outside, like, this is awesome to have because you can have a fire pit and you can actually enjoy it all year round. And this stairs has electrical, gas, water, and low voltage hookup for your speakers. And here you have a black cedar pergola, which is awesome to have. It allows for privacy. And then right over here, you have these nice planters. You know, again, once the summer is here, everything is green, everything is beautiful, and this is how you entertain in style. All right, now it's time I show you the lower level, and the staircase is gonna take us there. And by the way, guys, this door right here is the main entrance into the unit. This area is awesome. You could have a console table, you could have a mirror, and this is basically where you come in when you enter the home. And here we are on the lower level. As you walk onto the lower level, you notice these elegant porcelain floors. Very nice color, they're light, they're very clean. Here to the right, you have a wet bar. Very cool subway tile, Brizo plumbing fixtures. If you wanna have a secondary living room, this is ideal. If you wanna have a workspace, you can also do it on the lower level. And by the way, this kind of ceiling height and this kind of natural light is unheard of in duplex downs. So in my book, this is not a duplex down. Here's your front bedroom. Great size room, and technically this is a corner unit. So you have windows on that side, and you have, again, this massive window that is just so incredible to have and really makes this home very different from everything that's on the market. And this room is perfect as your guest bedroom, as your office, as your creative space. Basically, it can be whatever you want it to be. Okay, super impressed with the caliber of finishes in this lower level bathroom. So right over here, you have a double vanity in this really nice gray color, oversized mirror, these really cool light fixtures off the ceiling. Very mysterious, very edgy. I like them a lot. And the floor is very playful. It's black and white. It's kind of in line with the color palette of really the lower level. It's very strong. It's very clean. And notice the floor tile on the main floor actually continues onto the shower floor, which makes this bathroom look even bigger. And on all shower walls, you have this off-white subway tile that's actually installed vertically, and it's staggered with gray grout lines. And you have this nice niche, Hansgrohe fixtures. And of course, they took it all the way to the top to add a bit of a wow factor. Yeah, it's a really cool bathroom. And here's another bedroom, great size. And just like in the rest of the home, it has a swanky light fixture. All right, and here we are in the master. And guys, wow, look at the ceiling height. So because the main level is elevated in this part of the home, the ceilings in your master bedroom on the lower level are significantly higher than in the rest of the lower level. So I think these are like, I don't know, it's gotta be 12, 13 feet tall. I really like these swing arm sconces. And I have to give a lot of credit to the designer on this home, because light fixtures in every part of the home are so clearly expensive and so unique. And I think they really add a lot to the design of the home. They make the space feel more expensive. They add functionality, obviously. They create the right setting and the right mood. And I think they knocked it out of the park with the light fixtures. And through these French doors, you have your walk-in closet. Now, the developer has an allowance for your closet organizers, so obviously they're not installed, but in terms of the size, I think it's perfect. And now the master bathroom. It does feel like a spa caliber master, and this is the kind of master bathroom I would expect from this developer. Everything is pristine, everything is very tasteful. You have this oversized floating vanity. I like how they mixed and matched the matte black mirrors and the brass plumbing fixtures and the black candles. Very creative. And of course, there's lots of storage in every one of them, soft clothes, all that good stuff. Okay, let's talk about these gorgeous tile floors in this beautiful shade of gray with these perfect white grout lines. Do you guys know if this is a herringbone pattern or a chevron pattern? Leave a comment. Right over here is your oval freestanding soaking tub. Very nice. And here's the shower. Oversized tile. Look at the size of these large format tiles. They're insane. You can only fit one, two, two and a half. I think these are 48 tall. Oh my gosh, look at this. Look at the shower head. It's almost intimidating. It's like in your face. It's so expensive looking. And I should mention that in this bathroom, the main floors are heated, the shower floors are heated, and even your bench is heated. So it's nice and warm to sit on. Guys, as always, thank you so much for checking out this video. I'd love to hear what was your favorite design feature of this home. Leave a comment. And also, let me know what kind of property tours you would like me to tour. We've toured duplex homes, penthouses, mansions, churches. What are you into? Leave a comment, let me know. And with that, I'll catch you on the next video.